Okay, so you're doing keto and intermittent fasting, but your darn blood sugars are still high. What is going on? Where's the sugar coming from? It's coming from your liver and your kidney. There's something called gluconeogenesis, which means the formation of new sugar. And your body does always need a very small amount of sugar. You can't run 100% on ketones or fat. A small percentage of body tissue runs on glucose. So your body actually makes it out of non-carbohydrate sources. It'll make it out of fat, it'll make it out of protein, and it'll make sugar out of ketones. What controls this process is insulin. Insulin is supposed to turn off gluconeogenesis. When you have high sugar, despite not consuming sugar, what this means is there's low amounts of insulin. The insulin is really low in your body. Obviously, it might be too low. What condition would create a situation where you don't have enough insulin? Well, diabetes type 1, but that's very, very rare. Or insulin resistance, which is very, very, very common. What's interesting about insulin resistance is it creates high levels of insulin, but at the same time, that insulin is not working in the body, so you don't really have the benefit of that insulin shutting down gluconeogenesis because it's all about the receptor. So the receptor in your cell is not receiving insulin, so your body is going to sense low glucose. So basically, your insulin is dysfunction. Whoops. Oh. What can you do? Simply focus on improving insulin resistance. How do you do that? Number one, you start exercising more to burn off the sugar. And by the way, when you have high blood glucose that's not coming from your diet, it's not pathological. It's not going to create a disease like it would if you were to consume too much sugar from the diet. Second thing, you want to increase your fasting. Fast longer and do it more frequently. Three, increase more fiber, as in vegetables, because the fiber is consumed by your friendly bacteria, and then your bacteria starts making something called a small chain fatty acid, like butyrate, and butyrate helps improve insulin resistance. That's the connection. Apple cider vinegar, really, really good to help you with insulin resistance. Vitamin D, essential. Chromium, one of the best trace minerals. And I forgot zinc too. Zinc is also really, really good to help you with that. B vitamins, of course. Nutritional yeast is one of the best sources. Potassium and magnesium, part of the electrolytes, will help. Getting more sleep will greatly help your blood sugars and decreasing inflammation, since inflammation worsens insulin resistance. So anything you can do to decrease inflammation. But of course, if you're doing all this, that's going to bring inflammation down. I did create several videos on inflammation. I put a link down below for a little more data, because if you have this chronic inflammatory condition, that can kind of keep you from fully achieving your full goals with this situation over here. Okay, 11, just give it more time. This means that you've had this problem for quite a long time, and it's going to take time to reverse. It could take months. It could even take up to a year. But also focus on the other indicators, the other improvement. If you are feeling more energy and you're losing weight and you have no hunger and you have no cravings, so everything else is doing well, that means it's working. So just ride the wave, give it more time. Don't go back to carbs. All right, thanks for watching. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully, in the future, we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.